and welcome along. Today on Upton Farm, we are going to be taking our 7290R here. And we have this field. We're going to be doing some subsoiling with the Jimper here. So without further ado, let's jump in and get started. We'll start her up. There we go. Quite quiet, this. Quite quiet, this tractor, yeah. Right, we are going to use the... this, which is of course the GPS. Let's do an auto width, and yeah, I do need to swing it right around, line it up with the edge of the field. There we go. Right, and down, and away we go. So we'll do some of this in cab. It's quite nice actually, this. It's a good tractor, the 7R. I really like it, and it's nice and powerful for this job. It pretty much just about covers the whole thing. Right, and there we go. So we're subsoiling some of this map and ploughing other bits. I just wanted to vary it a little bit, to be honest. So that we had a different use of equipment and a few bits and pieces. And this subsoiler really works well. I really like these. And it works well both like this and with course play. So, yeah. Well worth having, I think. Though we did miss a spot then. I might just pull this in slightly. Go. There we are, and down. We'll see whether it misses anything here. No, it's doing alright. I think it's probably just the movement of the tractor. I don't mind missing a couple of small spots, but in general, we want to catch as much of the field as possible. Up our output. Now this isn't a field that you get as default on this map. It is one that we've bought because it is nice and near the farm, and I'm considering using this middle farm here as it's got a little bit more space than the starting farm. So we just added this in so that we could get some potatoes, so that we could test the pigs while we were doing the testing part on this map. So we just kept it because it's not a big field. That was the thing. It's not a very large field. Which also makes it great for an episode like this where we're doing subsoiling. Let's bring that. Turn it. Go. I might hide our lines as well. There we are. That's good. The edge of the field. Right, I think we're going to have to go. Oh no, because we've got a headland here, I'm not overly worried about that. We are going to have to extend out, probably on the next run actually. There we go. There's a slight little bit it misses, but I'm not overly worried about that. So I'm not quite sure what we're going to put in here. Actually, let's open it up to you guys. What would you like to see planted in this field? We had potatoes in here before, so really we're looking at a grain of some description, or possibly sugar beet. We don't have anything at the moment to... no, we should be alright actually. So yeah, let me know what you would like to see here. We are going to have a sugar beet harvester, so we are going to try and do a full range of crops on this map. We're going to be doing, we're going to be doing some planting soon, so... There we go. That takes us far enough. We're going to do pretty well actually with this. I think we're going to complete this fairly quickly, which is good. We are, yeah, our width is slightly off because we do, on the way back, we do leave a very little bit. I don't know if that's because of the ground response or whether that's something else, but yeah, it is certainly missing a small amount. Either that. Oh no, no, I must have been on the right course. I think we're gonna have to go back along that one. Yeah. We were on course then. I think that was to do with the slope of the hill. Right, so let's this time. Gonna just pull it in slightly. Nope, reset the offset. Take the work width down slightly. There we go. That way we should make sure we have some overlap now. Take that out and hide that. Rather have a little bit of overlap. I think it's sliding down the hill. I think because we're sort of at the angle, it is sliding down the hill. So we will go and clean that up afterwards. Otherwise, this is doing a fantastic job. Really is. As I said, I do like these subsoilers. Plenty of space to turn around here. So, of course, the big news is that this map has now been submitted to Giants for release by Lancey Boy. So, hopefully, we'll see it available to everybody in the near future. It really is a cracking map. I'm really enjoying playing this. And, yeah, well worth spending some time on. I love that you can get lost in this map. You really can. You can turn down a road and go, can I actually get out here? Can I get where I want to go with this? And you keep finding shortcuts and useful little ways of getting about. So it's, I love it for that. I love it for its complexity and its roughness. It feels a bit rough around the edges, this map, and I like that. I really do. And by that I mean rough in a good way. Some maps are rough around the edges and it just means they're unfinished. This is rough around the edges, and it simply, that just means that it's not unfinished. It just has a lot of character to it, and I love that. I feel like I'm in the British countryside with it. And that's why I look forward to playing it a lot more. Yeah. Last little bit up the top here, and then we will get onto our headlands. And it works again. I do like this seminar very much. I think this is Tech Muddings. Yeah, you can see the sliding and the fact that we didn't start really in the right place there. Right, line us up. The trouble is, if you start in slightly the wrong place with this, and then turn, it will—it won't quite work properly. It'll pull you off course. So you have to be careful of that. You have to be lined up to start with, otherwise you can end up off course the whole way along, which is kind of just demonstrated. Whereas now we're on the right course, things are going a bit smoother. I think we'll probably cultivate this all the while. We may have a direct seed that I can't remember at the moment. What I've set up with. Yeah, I think we've got a 6 meter direct seed if I remember correctly. One more, and that will keep it nice and clean. There we go. Right, and then we want to go round and get the headlands. And maybe clean up the middle of the field as well. Go. Right, so let's go around and get that. And we will start from the side here. We may have to do three. Not right. So actually, two will work down here, so it should be alright for that. We've left just enough to do there and back, which is perfect. this farm here is a really interesting area. Lots of sheds, but not a lot that closes up. And certainly storage space for things like hay and straw and things, but it's quite, the thing is, because everything's quite decentralized, there's nothing really close enough to there to do a lot of storage of hay and straw and things, except if you were looking to decentralize those things. We are going to have to do a third pass down the side here to get everything. Right, just drive back along the grass. We were all right along all of it except that last bit. I'm not massively worried about small patches. That won't reduce our yield that much. This is only a 10% boost doing this job does. Right. What we can do is, because we're going to end up the far side of the field, we will just run along that large road that's been missed. And just go over that and make sure that we get all of that. That will then be that done and that covered. The rest of it are just really small patches. Okay, small patches in the line, but they are small patches. Round we go. So, there we are. So yeah, let me know in the comments what you would like to see planted in this field. We will go and do another job in tomorrow's episode, and then we'll come back and plant this next week. So let us know what you want to see. Quite nicely, I think. Right, so that has basically got it. I'm really pleased with that. That's worked. That's, despite a couple of small bits missed, I think that we've covered that rather well. So I'm going to leave this episode here. A little bit shorter than normal, but I've enjoyed doing that. Thank you for watching. I hope you've enjoyed this episode. Please give it a like, drop us a comment, and give it a share. And for all the latest videos and live streams from Virtual Farmer, please subscribe to the channel. I will see you next time. Goodbye.